To those who played and enjoyed Tomodachi life, Miitomo, or heck, enjoyed the aspects of me in general, you will certainly enjoy Miitopia. When I first saw the Japanese version's gameplay, I already knew this was going to be a very quirky game given the previous Mii game. Miitopia is a very simple RPG that allows you to use your Mii as the player role of your adventure in the simple turn-based system. Though here's the catch, it not only allows you to choose and create your own party members, it allows you to use your Miis as NPCs throughout your adventure. Hell, this alone is what amused me enough to pick up the game personally. This is my one and only time I can choose Nicolas Cage as a villain.
Killing me won't bring back your goddamn honey!
Or various people I know in specific roles for shenanigans. So a lot of Miis in my collection never made the cut, but don't let that get you down. It's entertaining enough. Just to name a few, here are some random roles I've made for Miis I had. Iwata as the Great Sage, Robin Williams as a genie, Connie West as a shady merchant, and Hank Hill as the King. Haha, get it? Cause King of the Hill, cause he's the king. And of course various friends and animators that I know. The neat thing about this game is that you can either import all of your Miis from either the Mii Maker, Miitomo, and even Tomodachi Life. The story aspect of the game is very simple as a typical adventure would get. For the sake of explaining the story, I'll just use my Miis for certain roles. Basically, Miitopia was a peaceful world and everyone lived in harmony. Until Dark Lord Nicolas Cage disrupted the peace by stealing Miis' faces and placing them on monsters. I stumbled across such event and tried to warn the tour guide Brandon and other various people in town like Will Smith, Hitler, Emma, and Rosa. But it's too late and most of their faces get stolen. So it's up to me with Awakening class abilities along with Hirari to stop Nicolas Cage and his evil deeds and save the world. Because plot. See, the neat thing is that since you're using your own characters, it feels as if you're crafting your own story despite it being fairly straightforward. Despite it being an adventure, the map is more of a stage setup. Each area you watch your Miis walk, encountering 2 to 3 enemies before reaching the inn at the end of the map. Sometimes you have to revisit the area just to choose another path to get the chests, items, or story plot to clear the area 100%. The combat system is again as basic as it gets. A turn-based system with attacking turn based on your speed with skills and magic. As you progress through the story, you are able to create your party members and assign them quirks, such as their personality, job, and their battle cry. You are able to create 9 characters aside from yourself that are involved in the storyline, so choose them wisely. Though all I can say is you won't worry about just 10, as you'll freely make more, but 10 Miis will be the focus point of the story. The mechanics and skills are based on the classes, personality, and bond you have amongst the Miis. For example, in combat, if you have a person with a cool personality, they will sometimes act smooth and dodge attacks like they're used to it. Or having a stubborn attitude that will help endure, making you take less damage. If you have a princess class, you'll be able to dodge by letting someone carry you away. Bonding generally helps passively as well depending on the affection level between the Miis, such as one Mii warning another, helping them dodge an attack, or something as simple as showing off and double teaming one target. Now the only negative thing I have to say is that sometimes the combat gets repetitive. However, they make up for it due to the mechanics being very simple, so battles are very fast. Heck, you can even hit auto battle or fast forward the combat by holding down a button. While to me it doesn't take that long to grind, what makes up for it is the ability to feed your Miis. Feeding your Miis various meals increases certain stats, and it's basically the bulk of your stats, adding on to your overall stats. So needless to say, you gain stats at the end of each area, which allows you to progress the story without even worrying about grinding as much. For me, I like over-preparing for bosses to see how fast they get taken down. To me, this game is easy to pick up whether or not you're a turn-based RPG enthusiast or something in the casual pick-up and play aspect. It's charming when it comes to personality in its story and battles, and a legit RPG in its simplest term. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video, and please feel free to leave your positive and negative comments, as I do enjoy reading them. Alright, I'll catch you comrades later.